Well, this is not the video I was planning on making today, but my plan with me's are gonna have to wait. So as many of you know, I have been working really hard lately on trying to launch a course on sticker making in Affinity Designer. In this course, I'm gonna be teaching you all of the best practices that I found after literally years of agony and just countless hours spent in misery. And I feel like I sound like I'm being dramatic, but if you've ever gone through this experience, then you also know about all the tedious, mundane tasks that are just so frustrating. And when I discovered a way to solve all of my problems, I was like, I need to share this. I absolutely need to share this. But more on that in just a little bit, because the reason I'm posting this video right now is because some of you may have heard Canva just bought Affinity. And a lot of us have feelings about that, and I'm here to talk about those feelings. I need to put this down, it's too hot. So we're gonna be going over three different things today. Firstly, we're gonna talk about why I've chosen to use Affinity Designer as my program of choice, the reason that this is what I use to make stickers, and why this course is actually valuable and why I wanna teach it to you. Secondly, we're gonna talk about what you can expect from this course. So for those of you who are interested, you can kind of get a good idea of what it is that this course is gonna look like, and whether or not it seems like a good fit for something that you want to do. And then the third thing is we're gonna dive into this whole acquisition conversation and just kind of discuss it, because I don't feel like it's appropriate for me to not address this when I'm about to launch a course talking about Affinity Designer. So that's the plan. I'm gonna leave timestamps below so you can feel free to go to whatever it is that makes the most sense for you, or you can sit through the whole video if you want to. I appreciate you. But just know that those are available to you in case you want to skip around to a certain part. Okay, let's jump in. So the first thing that I want to talk about is, why do I design in Affinity Designer? When I first started making stickers, I was using Procreate because Procreate was a program that I was familiar with. And honestly, I love Procreate. There's no hate here whatsoever. Huge advocate for Procreate. Still, 100%. Use it. It's super fun. But when I decided that I wanted to start making stickers for my digital planners that I had been using since roughly about 2018, I found that everything I found was about doing it in Procreate, which seemed like a great idea to me at the time because I loved Procreate. Still do. But what I learned is that there are seriously so many hoops to jump through if you're using Procreate to make your stickers. But that's what like all the videos I could find on the internet were about. So honestly, I gave up. It just got to be too much for me and I was like, it's not worth my time. I am spending 80 to 90% of my time doing all of these like mundane tasks that are not what I signed up for when I decided I wanted to make stickers. And I was really only getting to spend maybe 10 to 20% of my time actually doing the creating part, the part that I wanted to do, that the part I wanted to make the stickers, right? So I gave up for a while. And I remember feeling like such a disappointment when one of my friends, who is a huge planner girly, kept asking me when I was gonna come out with more stickers. And I eventually just had to say, look, you probably don't realize this, but the amount of time that it actually takes to sit there and crop every single sticker, export every single sticker, name every single file, it's exhausting, especially if you're trying to put together a sticker set of anywhere between like 100 and 400 stickers. And it just feels like a really bad use of time. And so I did stop because I could not convince myself that it made any sense to keep going. And I started doing surface pattern design, and I happened upon quite a few teachers who were teaching how to do it in Affinity Designer. And that was really what my introduction to Affinity was. And I fell in love immediately. I had tried to learn pattern making in Adobe Illustrator before that. I had tried to learn Illustrator before that. And I really only learned enough to just get by. But Affinity Designer was mind-blowing to me in what it could do. But I had still never considered this being an option for sticker making. I honestly just kind of let go of sticker making and was just using my planner in a very basic way, and occasionally adding stickers when I felt like hand drawing them. But the more time I spent in this app, the more I kind of uncovered these little ideas here and there that seemed like maybe, just maybe, I could apply these to sticker making. And so I began to kind of hone this process, and I would say maybe like 8 to 12 months after I really started to explore this, I felt like I had gotten to a point where I was like, this is the perfect process, this is ready. And so I started a YouTube channel, and I started sharing my stickers with the world because I was ready to start sharing them again on my Etsy shop. And honestly, I am so glad that I did, but I'm also so incredibly glad that this now gives me an opportunity to share this process with you all. But the really cool thing about this process is, like I said before, I was probably spending like 20% of my time maximum doing the creative work. and 80% doing all the things that I really hated and loathed about sticker making. And now that has completely flipped. I would say I spend between 80 and 90% of my time doing the actual creative work that I love, and only 10 to maybe maximum of 20% of my time doing more of the tasks so easy anyone could do it kind of thing. Just time consuming though. Not to mention the fact that my sticker quality is actually significantly higher than it ever was before. So that's just an added bonus, and I do it all in less time. And so I'm honestly so excited to finally be sharing this game-changing method with you guys. So let's talk about that. I am going to be launching my course on April 22nd. I can't believe I'm saying that. April 22nd. I'm so excited, honestly. Okay, get it together, Tara. I'm really, really, really excited to share this. April 22nd. Okay. Which is Earth Day, I just realized.
Are you done?
But this launch is just going to be a beta version. So I've put a ton of time and effort into this, but I'm new to course making and I definitely want feedback. I feel like it's really thorough. I feel like I've done a really excellent job here, but I want your feedback. I need your help. So during this beta launch, I'm going to be offering this course at the cheapest price that it will ever be. And I'm actually going to do something for the next 10 days. I'm going to offer it at its absolute cheapest price. And then for the 7 days following that, before the launch date, the price is going to go up just a little bit. But then after that, the price will never be that price again. I will always launch it at a higher rate. So I'm inviting you all who are watching this now to join my founding members club. I am so excited. So excited. But yes, if you want to learn the most efficient way that I have found after years of going through all kinds of painstaking processes to figure this out, I'm here to hand it to you on a silver platter. I'll save you all the time and effort that I put in so that you don't have to. Okay, so what to expect in this course? What is this course even going to look like? So it is a 6-week course. There will be 6 modules and I will release them weekly on Mondays. Every single week, there will also be a live Q&A call where I'll answer all of your questions and just make sure that you are keeping up to pace with everything and that, yeah, you have no questions. I do leave a little bit of extra time in the course for implementation. And so there are some weeks with like bonus videos that if you're feeling really confident and you want to learn a little extra, you can, or if you want to slow it down and do it with me, you can. But some of these videos are optional. The idea of these weeks is really just that you have the time to fully invest in yourself and the new skills that you've learned so that you can truly master them and ask the questions while I'm around. This course is in fact geared toward beginners, so don't worry about that if you're feeling like you don't even know anything about Affinity Designer and you don't think you'll be able to do it. I break it down super simple from the beginning, so I promise you can do it. I believe in you. I also really hope to cultivate a very supportive community, so I hope that you walk away with a little bit of confidence and encouragement and support that you can do this and that your creative vision the world deserves to see. So you'll learn the basics of Affinity Designer, the benefits, a few ideas for different paths you can take in case you decide to go somewhere else outside of sticker making. We'll also talk about the less exciting but equally important legal side of things so that you can start to understand commercial licensing and what's okay to use, what's not okay to use, how to source inspiration. My entire creative process from start to finish, you can learn all of the time-saving hacks that I've discovered. And that's my personal favorite. That's like where I see the real value when it comes to sticker making. This is the part that will save you between like 20 and 50 hours with every single sticker project you make. And to me, that time is endlessly valuable. That is what I'm referring to as our magic module. It's going to take all the pain points that I had and that you probably also have if you've ever tried sticker making and just completely solve them. Poof. There'll also be a lovely little graduation ceremony at the end to recognize you and all of your hard work. And I think for the most part, that covers it. So we're going to be launching, like I said, April 22nd. And then between now and April 15th, the course is going to be being offered at $75. To me, this feels like such a steal, and I can't even believe that I'm offering it at $75. But for the next 10 days, to anyone who wants to be a founding member of this course, it is $75, and there are payment plan options available. After those 10 days are up, and for the following 7 days until the actual course launch on April 22nd, it's going to go up to $100. But let me just remind you, this is the beta pricing. I will never, ever launch this course at that rate ever again. So I really wanted this to be accessible to anybody who wanted to start, especially with the most recent announcement about the Canva acquisition of Affinity Designer. So I'll leave a link down below if you want to sign up for the course. Now, that all being said, we need to talk about this acquisition. So I'm not going to say anything super groundbreaking here. I'm just going to explain what I know and a little bit of speculation maybe. But if you want to really go down the rabbit hole, there are plenty of people talking about it and have been for the last week or so. So, you know, feel free if you're so interested in checking that out. But one of the greatest things about Affinity Designer is that it could do largely everything that Adobe Illustrator could do. I've found very few instances where I've been like,
oh man, if only I had Illustrator, because Affinity Designer just doesn't cut it.
I've basically never said that. And if I have, there are some pretty easy workarounds. But the crazy thing is that Adobe, as much as I love Adobe products, they're expensive. They really are. And Affinity Designer, at this point, costs $18.49 as a one-time fee. As a one-time fee. It's mind-boggling to me. I think that's absolutely crazy. But that is what it is. This gets you what's called a perpetual license. Not only that, the Affinity Designer program for the iPad is really amazing. And really, as much as I've grown to love Adobe Illustrator, their iPad version is just, it's not cutting it. And so I think being able to use the Apple Pencil on the iPad and draw with an Affinity Designer makes it even more accessible than even just the price point. Like, it is so easy to learn vectors in this way. And honestly, is in my opinion, very difficult to imagine how they charge so little for such an amazing program. Especially when like a month of Canva Pro costs pretty close to the same thing as Affinity Designer for the iPad. Canva Pro right now costs $14.99 a month. A month. And that's what scares me. So let's just dive into this. A lot of people voiced their opinions on this once the announcement of the acquisition was made. And shortly after that, these pledges came out. So the first one is the one that I'm most concerned about, and that is the perpetual licenses. They are claiming they will still exist. They're going to keep it fairly priced, keep it affordable. I want to believe this. I do. But they wouldn't be the first company in history to say that and then change it later on. So my thoughts are, if you're going to do this, now is the time to purchase, get that license, learn the program, and the rest we'll just kind of see what happens with. But I would say now is the perfect time. They do also have a suite of other programs that are very similar to Adobe Photoshop and Adobe InDesign. So if you are interested in getting the full licenses for those, that's also going to be significantly more expensive right now than it is in the Adobe suite, for example. So just putting it out there. I mean, I might be purchasing those myself because right now I just have Designer. The second thing they're saying is that they're going to be rolling out new features. So to me, this does sound like a good thing. Like, Canva's investment into this program does seem like it could be beneficial. I mean, I already think that the program is so great, but sure, there's always room for improvement, I suppose. But I think a lot of people are really thinking this is going to be mostly related to AI and incorporating that, because Canva has incorporated a lot of AI already into their own program. And honestly, like, programs like Photoshop and Illustrator, they have AI integrations as well. So yeah, I mean, I think it's inevitable. It's just a matter of time. And so it's going to at least make these Affinity programs more comparable to what's going on with the Adobe suite, at least. That's what I imagine. But who knows what else their investment might lead to. I will say that within my course, I'm not really planning on teaching anything AI related. It's not my thing. I think that there are certain ways it can be used as a tool, but really nothing that I use in my course, and none of the skills that I teach would really benefit from AI, in my opinion. I don't like it, okay? That's my opinion on AI and art. I'm not a huge fan. Anyway. The third point is actually that they're going to be doing similarly to what Canva does, making themselves available to registered nonprofits and schools free of charge, which I think is an absolutely amazing thing. And the only thing I can see this for, like, the future is that maybe this helps the Affinity programs become more mainstream, which is only good news for anyone who's learning these programs now. And so, yeah, I definitely recommend learning them now. I think it's a good idea. I think if these are available for kids in school who are starting to learn design, I think it's just a matter of time until they become more readily accepted in the whole design world. So yeah, I think they might be giving Adobe a run for their money. Okay, and then the very last thing that they mention here is just that they're open to feedback. So yeah, I guess we just voice our opinion and see what they do with it. But ultimately, it's now Canva's business, so they're going to do what they want with it. And yes, like I said, that scares me. So I think that now is the best time. Learn Affinity Designer, go get that license, pay the one-time fee, and the rest we'll just have to see what happens. But if you do want to learn from the basics, how to use Affinity Designer and how to apply that to sticker making, then I have totally got you covered. Check out the link for my course down below. Class starts on April 22nd. Ah, I'm so excited. I hope to see you there as part of my founding members club. If you have any questions, please, please, please put them in the comments below so I can address them and we can help everyone who has these questions understand what this course is about. So, okay, that's it. That's all for me today. As always, thank you guys so much for tuning in. I appreciate you. You're the best. I love you so much. And I just realized that my tea is cold. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.